habit. Well, he was a comet hunter in the late 1700s. And he put together this list, all right? Each one of these objects is a deep sky object that he discovered. And they're really bright. There are all kinds of things that we can see, and they're littered around the sky. And we call them Messier objects, after Charles Messier. All right, so we can't see them without a telescope. And this is where they are tonight, by the way. So what do you think the M stands for?
Messier.
There's 110 of these. This is a popular list. Even if you have light-polluted skies, you can see most of these objects. And if you don't have a telescope, go to your local library. A lot of libraries today are beginning to loan out telescopes, so I highly recommend you check in on that. But I'd like to go out to a place in space that's under the belt of Orion. All right, the three stars that represent this belt are here. Their names are Al-Natak, Al-Nalam, and Mintaka. Right, below that are three stars, and that center star, the central one, see it's a little fuzzy looking, like a cloudiness to it? Well, that's a nebula. And, well, the word nebula means cloud, all right? And Charles Messier was looking for these nebulae, or found these nebulae, and that was a really bright one, and he marked it number 42. So we also call it Messier 42. Now, we're not stuck on Earth. We're going to fly out to this object, and I'm going to brighten things up here a bit. And I mentioned briefly earlier on in the program, the father of modern physics, who was that? Albert Einstein. So Albert Einstein, in addition to theorizing black holes and bent space and time, discovered that nothing can travel faster than the speed of light. All right, but in a planetarium, we get to do that. So this object that we're going out to is about 1,000